This video is brought to you by the Brown Lab at Virginia Tech. Hey everyone, in this tutorial, we're going to go over how to use the command line to create high quality visualizations. You can use the chapters or the timestamps in the description to skip to each part of the tutorial. Links to everything will be posted below. Biomolecules exist as three-dimensional entities comprised of building blocks and can make up complex subunits. Scientists can use different techniques to create 3D structures of these molecules. A common format for these structures is the Protein Data Bank format, or PDB. This format contains a list of atoms found in each protein residue and assigns them an X, Y, and Z coordinate. In this part of the tutorial, we will apply some of the tools mentioned earlier to create a good visualization of a potassium channel calmodulin complex, KCNQ1. KCNQ1 is a pore-forming subunit of a cardiac potassium channel that binds to calmodulin, and when mutations occur, can cause congenital long QT syndrome, which is a propensity for irregular heartbeats. Let's load in the model by typing open 5VMS into the command line. This fetches the crystal structure from rcsb.org. Alternatively, the PDB file can be downloaded from the protein databank and open using the open option on the home menu. Now, let's create copies of the protein. In the command line, type sim pound 1 assembly 1 copies true. The sim command is used to create symmetrical copies. Pound 1 assembly 1 specifies which protein to make copies of. Copies true means these symmetrical copies are loaded as complete models, not just graphical clones. This can also be written as copies T. In this case, we only have one open protein, so it is given the ID of 1. If you have multiple open proteins, check the model panel and select the correct ID. After the copies are loaded, we can type close pound 1 to close the original protein and give us more space in the model panel. Let's turn the protein so that we're looking down the channel. We can do this by using the orient button in the graphics menu or by typing view orient. Let's take a look at the other side of the channel and zoom in a little bit. We can do this by typing zoom 1.1 semicolon turn x 180. These are two different commands that we can run in a single line by separating them with a semicolon. Now let's display the surface of the channel. Typing surf forward slash A shows only the surface of chain A. Using the command line here is more efficient, but the same thing can be done by selecting all copies of the chain by going to select chains potassium voltage gated channel all, and then clicking the show surfaces button in the molecule display menu. To prevent clipping from the cartoons of chain A, we can hide them by typing hide forward slash A cartoons. In this case, there's no visual difference. Let's hide some bonds to clean up the image. We can hide the residues and bonds with the green calcium ions by typing hide forward slash B. This technically hides the whole of chain B, but the hide command by default only hides atoms and bonds. If we still want to see just the calcium ions, we can type show CA. Be careful, capitalization is important here. There are still a few visible bonds that we can hide by typing hide P bonds. To make the cartoons appear nicer, we can change the style of the helices. Type car style mode H tube to change the style to tubes. Car style indicates that we are changing the cartoon style. Mode H tube specifies that only the helices should be shown as tubes. We can improve the lighting by typing lighting gentle. This is like the soft lighting with shadows option from the graphics menu. Now, set the background color to white with set BG white, or by clicking the white background button in the graphics menu. White backgrounds are important for publication images since they provide better contrast and they save ink for print publications. Next, enable silhouettes by typing set sil t or by clicking the silhouettes button in the graphics menu. We can increase the silhouette depth and contrast by typing set silhouette depth 0.02. To emphasize the calcium ions more, type size ions atom 1.6. This increases the size of any ions shown. The view and texture of this model look good, but let's make the colors more appealing. Starting with the calcium ions, we can change their color by typing color mod ions hue plus 45. Colors are subjective, and you can also change them by selecting ions and coloring them in the Actions tab. Now let's change the color of the rest of the structure by typing rainbow palette PUBU-5. The rainbow command colors a structure with a variety of colors instead of just one. Palette PUBU-5 sets the options of colors on a scale from white to dark blue. By default, the rainbow command colors by residue, so in this case, the residues closest to the N-terminus are white, and the residues closest to the C-terminus are blue. Try typing help palette and clicking on the palette link to see a complete list of palettes. Let's try one more coloring option. Type rainbow polymers palette PUBU-5. This colors the calmodulin and the channel different colors. Finally, we can save the image by clicking the Save button in the Home menu. Name your picture and change the file type to PNG or JPG. By default, the file extension is CXS, which allows you to save a session file if you want to come back to it later. Be sure to take note of where you're saving your files so you don't lose them. Congratulations, you just made your first high-quality visualization using Chimera X. I hope this tutorial gave you the tools and knowledge to start making your own high-quality visualizations. If you have any questions, you can leave a comment below. And as always, thanks for watching.